is Jean Morrison. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Biostatistics. So my relationship with the Precision Health resources was that I used them in a class. So for the class, we really wanted to give students exposure to electronic health records and sort of more complex health data resources. And so it was a really good opportunity for us to do that. So we ended up having our students look at trying to predict hospitalizations using diagnosis codes that patients had received in the past. I think specifically having the Precision Health data as opposed to like a more traditional study, it's just a lot more data and it has kind of complexities that other types of data don't have because it's collected as EHRs and not as research data. It's complicated in different ways and in ways that, you know, they might encounter if they're working with EHRs in the future. I guess the challenge for us was it's really getting the students exposure to a range of different types of data. So the Precision Health data, as it's set up, it's a bunch of different databases. So that's kind of a different thing than they're used to. Maybe our students are used to just getting like a CSV file and it's flat and it kind of lays out exactly what they're supposed to do. Whereas the Precision Health data, you know, it's got databases for different types of things a patient might do, encounters or diagnoses or medications that they're on or lab values. And so it gives an opportunity for the students to be more creative with it. And it's also, it asks a little bit more of them in terms of processing the data. So it asks them to, rather than just taking a data set that's handed to them, do some thinking about how do I want to take this kind of raw data and turn it into information. I had a really good time working with this data this year, and I would love to use it again in different ways. And I think I would probably love to use it in my research, and I just haven't gotten to that. In my research, I do a lot of genetics, and so MGI is a great resource for that. So being able to combine like genetics with sort of complex medical histories provides a lot of opportunity. I think especially for things like prediction problems where you want to know, right, is somebody going to be diagnosed with a disease in the next year, or is somebody going to have a particular kind of event in the next year? Those are the kinds of problems that I think really captivate me about this data. I think there's a lot of different things that you could do with it, though. I did hear from students, many of them had a fun time working with that data. It was like a different thing than they've ever gotten to do, and they were able to sort of speak about it in job interviews. They were able to say, yeah, I've worked with electronic health records data, which is sort of a unique opportunity.